Here's my latest thrift store find. It is a Sony Super Betamax VCR, model SL-390. There you can see the price I paid. This model is from 1989. It is not a stereo VCR, but it does have Super Betamax, which was an improvement in the picture quality over regular Betamax. You can see a switch here for Super Beta to turn it on or off. And there's some kind of switch here for color. I'm not sure what difference that makes. It's three positions. I'll have to see if Sony's website has the manual for this, because I know they have a lot of manuals for older products, but not everyone. So hopefully they have the manual for this. Supports recording in beta 2 or beta 3 mode, which were different recording lengths, similar to SP and EP speeds on VHS. I like how it even says fluorescent display over the fluorescent display. Super Beta high quality picture super mechanism. And there's the recording button. It has sharpness and tracking controls. I did not get this with the remote, but there are plenty of buttons on the front panel to control it with. On the back, it's fairly simple. It has RCA jacks for input and output, antenna terminals, and a channel 3 and 4 switch for the RF modulator. And here's the information. SL390, made in Japan, of course. And the date code is 9C, which means it was made in 1989. Because I highly doubt this is from 1999. Although I believe Sony was actually still making beta VCRs that recently, but not something like this. I plugged it in, turned it on at the store, and it did power on, but there were no tapes to test it with. But I do happen to have one beta tape. It's an L750, 222 meters. And let's see, at beta 2 speed, it can record 3 hours, or at beta 3 speed, it can record 4 hours and 30 minutes. This machine does not support recording at beta 1 speed. It can only play back beta 1. It cannot record, but if I had an older model, such as one of the original Betamax machines, which only supported beta 1, I would get an hour and 30 minutes at this length of tape. So here it is plugged in. You can see the flashing clock. So let's turn it on. And the TV tuner comes to life. It is set to beta 2, and Super Beta is on. So I'll put in the tape. Supposedly this tape has been erased, at least according to what I've been told, but we'll see if maybe there's some remnants of these recordings on it, if this machine even works. So here we go. Let's try it out. Okay, let's hit play. I'm getting something on the display. Ah, it's trying to play, but maybe this corruption could be because somebody tried to bulk tape erase it, and that's not necessarily the fault of this machine while it's the tracking is so bad. But let me try adjusting the tracking here. That's a little bit more steady when I moved it down there. If I turn it the other way, about the same, but it's actually worse in the middle. Let me try fast forwarding. It has a little LED above the control there. You can see if I turn down the exposure, because this camera tends to overexpose. Let me try fast forwarding. There's an orange or yellowish LED above the fast forward indicator. Surprisingly, there is not a tape counter on the display, unless there's some switch to, oh, here it is, clock slash counter. Alright, let's start playing that. Let's hear if we get any audio. Do hear some audio, but it's kind of garbled. But, like I said, we can't judge it based on that. picture quality, because the tape may have been bulk tape erased and maybe it just wasn't a complete erasure. So what I'm going to do, and the whole reason why I'm using a analog Hi8 camcorder to record this, I'm going to connect its video output to the video input of this VCR and try to do a recording on Betamax. Okay, as you can see, I got the video output of the camcorder connected to the VCR, and the cover is removed because off camera I had my first tape eating incident with this VCR. At first they wouldn't rewind the tape, and then when I tried to eject it, it got stuck halfway. And it still has problems inserting and ejecting the tape. I think probably the belt responsible for that is worn out. But I did at least get it to load the tape, and I was able to fast forward and rewind it. So rather than try to tempt fate by trying to eject this once again, I'll just try to record now using the video from the camcorder as the source. I reset the camera to zero. Now let's try recording. Looks like it's trying to record, so if I can play this back, you'll see this part of the video as played from Betamax.
Mommy, were you ever naughty when you were little?
Once or twice.
Did Santa Claus ever punish you?
Where did you get an idea like that, hon?
Grandpa.
Looks like it's trying to record, so if I can play this back, you'll see this part of the video as played from Betamax on this Sony Super Betamax SL-390 VCR from 1989. Okay, as you could see in that first test recording I made, the quality was absolutely terrible. It's barely watchable. So I decided to clean the heads. I used the Dr. Cassette method of soaking a strip of paper in alcohol and holding it up against the head as I spin the head drum. And that seems to have done the trick, because there's still some noise in the picture, but it's a drastic improvement. So I'm recording this in Super Beta at Beta 2 speed. This time I have it connected to my little Sony Handycam, so I'll have this connected to my computer via FireWire to do the capture when I play this back from beta tape. So this is the Sony SL-390 Super Betamax VCR from 1989. In mostly working condition, it plays and records and fast forwards and rewinds. It just has some trouble inserting and ejecting the tape, probably because the belt for that is either worn out or it's snapped and it's not even there anymore. So I have to sort of help it manually to get the tape in and out, but once it's in, it works okay. So this should be fully restorable. Not bad for a thrift store find.
Where the temperature this Christmas Eve is still holding in there at 21 degrees at 7 o'clock. Well, we hope Santa is dressed warm tonight, don't we?
Going
on. Got a ways to go yet. Yeah.
So now we're back to Hi8 for this part, and let me try to rewind what I just recorded. Okay, that works. So I'll hook up the video capture and try to record this into the computer. So I'll probably need to get new belts for this, but so far this has been my first time using a Betamax VCR, because my family never had Beta. When I was a kid, we were a VHS family, as most were in the late 80s and early 90s. But somebody out there bought this in 1989, which was pretty much after Beta really had fallen out of favor. I don't think you could even get movies on Betamax in 1989 anymore. Maybe by mail order, but definitely not in stores or in rental places. So it must have been some Betamax diehard out there who still wanted to be using it in the late 80s. So there you go, the Sony Betamax SL-390 VCR from 1989.